Another standard integral that we have to prove is dx upon under root a square minus x square. Now, I have in the denominator root. So, again, I have to go with some substitution. Let me go with trigonometric substitution. But what to substitute in place of a? X, that is not in place of a. So, it is a square minus x square. If I substitute x as a secant theta like the previous video, does it help me? No, because a square secant square theta will come. A square definitely will go outside in form of a. 1 minus secant square theta, no formula for it. It is secant square theta minus 1. But what if I substitute x is equal to a sine theta or a cos theta? If x is equal to a sine theta, its square is a square sine square theta. Coming out as common, it becomes 1 minus sine square theta, which is cos square theta. At least a formula exists. So that I will do. I will substitute x is equal to a sine theta. Let's see how to do it. I write proof and I know what to do now. I have to put x is equal to a sine theta. My dx is equal to a cos theta d theta. Right? If this is my equation number 1, this can be made as equation number 2. Just put in the question dx upon under root a square minus x square. Put values, dx is nothing but a cos theta d theta from your equation number 2. And under root a square minus x square, a square as it is minus x square is a square sine square theta. And I write from 1 and 2 because it is because of these two equations that I am writing it. Next what we can do is a square is there. Let's take common, 1 minus sine square theta is cos square theta. In the under root, it becomes cos theta. So, a cos theta, d theta. In denominator, also a cos theta. Because of the similar obvious reasons, usage of sine square theta plus cos square theta is equal to 1. That is why I have done this. Cancel whatever cancels. Integration of 1 d theta is nothing but theta plus c. What is theta? Theta from equation number 1 is nothing but sine inverse x upon a. So, it is sine inverse x upon a plus c, and that is from my equation number 1, and that is what I needed to prove, that the value that we have for dx upon under root a square minus x square integral is sine inverse x upon a plus c.